605 Atlantic Avenue. A month ago when I spoke about the ills of tax abatements and how we need money for swimming pools and other things in the city, afterwards a couple of people came to me and said, Avery, are you for real? Did you do that? I told them, yes, I built three swimming pools in East Orange. And I also expanded the senior center. And we were one of the first to put security lights and the cameras in the senior housing so that they could view who was ringing the doorbells. But what was unique about East Orange was, which you don't have and maybe you can't do it, we had an engineering department, we had public works, we had a law department, and we had planners, and we worked together, and we visited the communities. In East Orange, they had districts. And I would go to the district meetings and I'd say, what is it you need in this community? And I would bring it back. And we'd make plans. And if there was some federal funding, we would get a piece of it. Because we had a lawyer of hand in, we had the engineer. And you can check with the owner of Washington Manor, Bill Eaton. He was our lead attorney. And he was able to move in fast and we'd get things done. And there was not a program that the federal government put out of the state that we didn't get money on. And it's the same thing we're doing at the Board of Education. That's how we got those schools built. So they said, Avery, we don't believe what you did. That's why I'm wearing the hat. You can see this city engineer and EO1 means I was the first on rail. And here's a plaque, a copy of the plaque where I built a swimming pool and a recreation center. And what does it say here? Funded by a safe, clean neighborhood program. It was not city money. But since you don't have the city money, we're giving money away with the tax abatements. And it's really disgusting. Because we do need money for a swimming pool, we need money for extend our summer education program. And I almost had a swimming pool here, working with Freehold and Nara's Attic, but he had promised it to Wolf Hill in Oceanport, and he never did build it. But I did get the homeless shelter being built. But what I'm saying to you is that if you work together with the community and you work together with your staff, you can get things done. And that makes people happier. It's not normal for me to come out and talk like this, but I'm getting a little disgusted with this operation, particularly with the tax abatements. And the fact that we need money, and I said I'm paying almost $7,000 in taxes, and I'm a senior and on fixed income. So you've got to show some sensitivity, and you've got to find, I know you say you had a 100-day program. Well, how did you develop that? Did you get input from the community? If you did, then that's good. If you didn't, then that's a problem. You got to know what the people want, and you need to know what can be done. But we were able to because Essex County, as I told you before, was a center of power. And they would always step up for it. In fact, Don Payne offered me the job of the county engineer. And I said, no, I'm happy where I am. I'm going to fool around with that. But you could go to them or you could go to the governor. And they would respond. So I'm saying I would hope that you could assume that attitude and respond to the community. Because there are things that need to be done, and people are saying Long Branch is not the Long Branch we have. We have no amusement for our kids. And I was trying to stop that when I ran for mayor before. I was going to say, we need those saved back. Because that was fun, and my son worked at the Haunted House. So I'm saying to you that, and those who doubted that I was a city engineer, I did all this stuff. I don't know if they're here tonight. But I hope you know it clear that it takes a concentrated effort and a team. And as I said, we had the legal department, and they were, and you can talk to Bill Eaton, he says that his main job was keep me out of jail. That's true. Because if there was a need, I would respond, and we could find a way to do it. I told you, I bought 5 police cars for the police, for the government program. But the only trouble is we bought it from the state, and they had Crown Victoria. Ford Crown Victoria, and they broke my budget. And I had to go down to the local government down in Trenton to get a transfer made, approval transfer. But that's because we responded, because they were going to use those vehicles, put them in the community, and let the policeman be able to have them parked outside the house so people feel safe. But that wasn't good. I could be here all night, but I've got things to do.